Welcome to the interview show. This is Scott Wood, your host. I am in the tour van belonging to a band called Braids. I've got one member of the band here with me. I would love it if you could introduce yourself.
I'm Raphaelle.
And what would you be doing in this band called Braids?
I'm the singer and lyricist, and I play other instruments.
I've been in a lot of tour vans, and this is the first one where there's been flowers in the front seat, so I'd love it if you could describe these flowers.
They're orange because right now it's fall, so it's nice to have a little bit of festive flourishment in the vehicle. And I find that it just helps with the general like upkeeping of the morale and cheeriness of the van, because it can be it's so disconnected being in a van all day and driving on the road and just stopping at gas stations. So it's kind of nice to get a little bit of nature. It's really pretty, it smells really nice, and it's always enjoyable picking out the bouquet. And I have three little pumpkins on the dashboard also because it's fall right now.
So now we are going to take a moment and we're going to sniff these flowers.
They're good. They smell really nice. See?
Wow. Good? This is the most inviting tour van I've been in for a while.
Mm-hmm. I spent all goddamn day in it, so it's nice to have it feel a little bit good.
So, Braids, I'm going to talk a bit about music because I'm a radio guy. This is a radio interview, and your songs are super long, which is one of my arch enemies, songs over 5 minutes. So, I'd love you.
Why is it? Why is it an arch enemy?
Because I have a half an hour show, so if I play 2 7-minute songs, half the show's done.
Well, I guess it's a good thing because it makes you question what it is you're super dedicated to. Because the longer the songs, the less choices that you have, so the more gung-ho you need to be about the choices that you're going to make.
That's absolutely true. I think I'm being challenged here.
Yeah, definitely.
All right, so I'm going to play a song now. Let's see if my choice is a good one.
Yeah, I guess so. Hey, I'm in a band called Braids. Oh, I forgot my name. It's Raphaelle. And I'm in that band called Braids. You're listening to an interview thing. Maybe I should try it again. Hey, I'm Raphaelle from the band Braids, and you're listening to the interview show?
With Scott Wood.
Just a soft girl who looked like myself. White-cheeked and bleak, knowing all the answers. Thank you. Hey, this is Raphaelle from the band Braids, and you're listening to the interview show with Scott Wood.
Welcome back to the interview show. This is Scott Wood, your host. You just heard In Kind. That's off the record Flourish, Perish.
That's a really long song. You didn't have to choose that one. We have Victoria. Isn't that like 4 minutes? In Kind is like 8. There's lots of good songs on the record that are shorter.
Lucky for me, I play more than one song.
Oh. So are you going to choose another really long song? No? Okay.
I don't want to get too ahead of ourselves here, but I do pick some shorter songs.
Okay.
So anyways, the song you just heard was called In Kind. That's off the second record by a band called Braids. The record's called Flourish, Perish. I've got Raphaelle from the band here with me. I'd love it if you could say a few words about this one.
It's a song that took a really long time to write. It was written in a live environment, which is the only record, or the only song on the record that was. It goes through a lot of movements, which I think is something that we've kind of steered away from, but are coming back around to. It's pretty banging.
Braids, you've just released your second record, Flourish, Perish. Congratulations. Most Braids fans will notice that you've lost a member along the way. Her name is Katie. I'd love it if you could talk a bit about that.
I don't feel that it's exactly necessary, because we've talked about it a lot, and I think something that has kind of happened along the way of talking about it is people have really fixated on the drama as opposed to our music. And I think, you know, we're a band. I'm definitely not like a tabloid magazine, or I don't have like a gossip blog or anything like that. So I don't know. I think we lost a member along the way. I miss her. We weren't seeing eye to eye creatively, and that's just kind of the way that we're going to leave it. And I think it's more important to listen to our music than to care about that stuff.
Sure, you can understand, though, how fans are going to notice there's one less member, a little bit of a change in sound.
It's interesting because only people in Canada really care about it, I've noticed. Well, like, people, like, kind of get upset, like, on Twitter or something. But yeah, bands go through changes just as people do. You know, there's lots of breakups, especially in the time that you're, you know, in your 20s. I've had so many friends who moved in together and they lasted like 6 months or they lasted 2 years, and it just happens. I think relationships end and new relationships flourish, and there's not really much to say. Like, nobody was in the room going through what we were going through, and I think that it would be a shortcoming to try and explain it. And we're all in better places now, and things were tumultuous, and I think things are now healing, and we have a really beautiful record that is also hers to show for something that we all had to overcome in different ways. So
the new record, Flourish, Perish. The new record also marks another big change. You ditched guitars in favor of programming and sequencers. I'd love it if you could talk about this decision.
It was just music that we had been listening to didn't really involve guitars anymore. It was a lot more programmed and sequenced, but still very human and still very thoughtful. Panther du Prince and Max Cooper, Stefan Bodson, I guess kind of heavier electronic artists. We've been on tour with a couple of bands who had really influenced those desires in us. Baths, definitely an amazing artist, and we saw him performing electronic music live, and we were like, wow, I'd really like to do that. Same with a band called Born Gold, which is from Canada. Used to be known as Gobble Gobble, and it's interesting that people get so attached to the sound of guitars. I don't know, that happened to Bob Dylan, you know, even though like he was still in the realm of guitars, but when he switched over from acoustic guitar to electric guitar, like, people freaked out. And I think like one of the most important parts of Braids, like the songwriting, I think is still really there, even though the sonics have changed. Definitely guitar is something that I'm coming back to. I have a guitar, just a little acoustic guitar back there that I've been playing a lot and I've been writing songs on, and we just wanted to try different sonics within the songwriting. So, because if you listen to electronic music, it's like so different than the music that we're making, like the formula and everything, and like the addition and subtraction of parts, it's like completely different. So
I've heard you say that electronic music is the most emotional kind of music, and I'd love you to talk a bit more about that.
I think what I was talking about with electronic music is it feels very much like it's embracing where it is that we are. It being 2013 and all of us, you know, having iPhones and being super connected with social networking and all of us owning laptops and having these amazing recording programs. And I think it's really offering us the opportunity to really accept, I guess, where life has taken us with regards to technology, and also connecting that with our emotions. And I think it's like, it's really interesting territory that is just being discovered. And I think new territory always brings about a lot of vulnerability and a lot of really kind of raw emotions. And I think it's that discovering of those that is bringing about something really human and emotional. And at least I'm finding, like, in a lot of electronic artists, it's just like, even though it is computer-based music, it's still being made by a person. And I think that's something that we forget about when we listen to electronic music. And it's just like so moving. Some of the artists that I've listened to, like Burial, is a beautiful example of something that is like so emotional for me. And yeah, there's so many artists, electronic artists, that I really look to feel something from. Hey, this is Raphaelle from the band Braids, and you're listening to the interview show with Scott Wood. Thank you. Hey, this is Raphaelle from the band Braids, and you're listening to the interview show with Scott Wood.
Welcome back to the interview show. This is Scott Wood, your host. You just heard Fruined off the second record by Braids. The record's called Flourish, Perish. I've got Raphaelle here with me in her tour van. I'd love it if you could talk a bit about this track.
Fruin's a track that really just goes, and like it just chugs, and I really like that. Sometimes I get pretty crazy insomnia, and this is about one of those times where I hadn't really slept for about 3 days and was feeling really weird about things existing. So the lyrics are about that.
So I wanted to play a track from your first record, Native Speaker. I was going to let you choose that track. I'm not going to be able to play the whole thing because you guys have really long songs, but I thought I'd play a little bit and then come back and get you to talk about looking back at that track.
I'm wondering which track I would be okay with you dimming down. I guess Lamekin is like an interesting song, so I feel like that was a song that was kind of moving us towards the direction that we're in now.
All right, so we're going to listen to Lamekin off Native Speaker by the band Braids. When we come back, we're going to talk a bit about that track.
Hey, this is Raphaelle from the band Braids, and you're listening to the interview show with Scott Wood.
Welcome back to the interview show. This is Scott Wood, your host. You just heard Lamekin by a band called Braids off their debut record, Native Speaker. I've got one of the members of the band here with me. I'd love it if you could talk a bit about this track, Looking Back.
I wrote this song with like a bunch of vocal harmonies, and it was all coming out like one line. It sounded really shitty and just like a big cluster of sound, and I showed Taylor it, and he's like, oh, this is really nice, like we should learn how to sing this and how to play it and how to divide it up. It was the first time that we had really done something that was a cappella, like that was just voices. It was very challenging. It's difficult for four people to learn how to sing in tune together and to really play off of each other, and I guess it was like that subtraction of guitars, you know, which is the sound that we have now. Yeah, I don't know, it feels a little bit more electronic. And I really like the name Lamekin. It's an old English word or saying, I guess, for the weakness of a lamb. So it's the lyrics are, I can't stop it. So it's kind of about feeling weak like a little lamb.
The first record, Native Speaker, that was a time when a lot of people called you Animal Collective at their most hormonally charged. Do you still feel that way?
Sure, I was super hormonally charged. I think I still am, but I just don't think I write about it in the same way. 20s.
All right, it's the end of the interview. Raphaelle's been so nice to sit in this van with me. She's been driving all day and did not want to do the interview in the tour van. What's a tactic you've used to somehow endure this interview?
I was like, all right, we're doing it. All right, he asked me a little bit of an uncomfortable question at the beginning, but I've been asked this question so many times about, you know, departures and things like that. I was like, I am just going to enjoy the rest of this interview, and there are some nice flowers here, and I don't need to feel pouty about this, and he's a nice guy. So I had those thoughts as we were going through the questions.
At the end of the show, I love the guest to pick one of their own tracks and talk a bit about it as I bring up the music. But you got to pick the track off the first record, Native Speaker. So I'm going to pick the last track off Flourish Parish, your second record. I'm going to pick the track Girl.
Oh, that's so nice. You know what would have maybe been better to play than Lamekin, than my choice? Is Native Speaker, because I feel like Girl is very much kind of down the same vein as Native Speaker. But if you're listening and you've had a good time listening, you could check out the song Native Speaker after listening to the song Girl, because it's kind of beautiful and similar.
I read that Girl is the one track off the second record that you've consistently liked.
Yes, that's true. I've never not liked it.
And so for other songs, why do you like or dislike or go through various waves of different conflicting feelings about them?
Oh, that's difficult. Let me think about that. Perhaps because Girl is so simple. There's only really two elements in it. So there's not a lot to be confused about, whereas with other songs there's like so many parts, there's different movements, there's drums, there's mixing, there's effects, there's lyrics, there's, oh my god, there's so many things. But with this song there's just a piano line and there's a vocal line and they're following each other, and there's not really much else to get confused about. So it's something that I liked when I did it, and it's something that I continue to like.
All right, we're going to listen to Girl by a band called Braids. Thank you very much for being on my show.
Thanks for having me. Sorry if I got, you know, heated at the beginning, but it was nice talking to you.
It's all right. It's perfectly allowed.
Most definitely. Hey, this is Raphaelle from the band Braids, and you're listening to the interview show with Scott Wood.
Carpet that once more. Like